Some people in Bayou Pigeon who have developed a mystery disease got what they wanted today.
State health workers took samples of their water to test for bacteria. As we showed you earlier, about a dozen people along Vaughn Road in Bayou Pigeon have developed bladder or kidney infections recently. They suspect their water is to blame because the infections began after the parish opened a new water purification plant. So, state officials took three investigative water samples from their neighborhood today. They say the results should be back early next week. However, state health officials point out they test for bacteria in every public water system once a month. So the chances of Vaughn Road's water being responsible for the recent infections, they say, are slim.
And speaking of water, Louisiana has earned yet another dubious distinction. According to environmental reporter Marvin McGraw, our state is near the top of another list. This time, it's water pollution.
Louisiana's water pollution problems have been legendary. And despite efforts in recent years to clean up our waterways, at least one national environmental organization says they continue to be a dumping ground for industry and municipalities. In a report from the U.S. Public Interest Research Group, Louisiana ranks fifth in the nation in the total number of violations of the Federal Clean Water Act.
Again, Louisiana industry is not being a good neighbor in communities.
Today, environmental groups wasted no time responding to the new information.
I think people are beginning to think that the issuing of permits is beginning to be a little bit of a joke here in Louisiana. Maybe it is a permit to pollute.
But state environmental officials argue the numbers don't tell the whole story.
I really have to take exception with calling some of these things that are apparently being listed as significant violations.
Dale Gibbons says the report fails to distinguish between real pollution violations and simple paperwork infractions.
In many cases, it was for one or two times of having exceeded a particular parameter or failed to get a report in on a timely manner, rather than for citing significant discharges of some toxic pollutant or anything else.
Gibbons claims that increases in enforcement have led to less pollution in recent years, but some feel in the case of our waterways, just a little pollution is too much. I'm Marvin McGraw, Channel 2 Eyewitness News.
You may recall the EPA's toxic release inventory ranked Louisiana number one in the amount of toxic discharges to our water, land, and air.